for checking out my channel. Thank you for clicking on this video. This video is part of the series of videos I post to try to help people out when it comes to attitude tests, like the civil service exam, UPCATLA, IFILSET, and all of those things. Today is part of our Math Monday series, in which I try to help you out sa isang math topic every Monday. So if this is the first video that you're watching from this channel, don't forget to hit subscribe, hit the bell icon para malaman ninyo as soon as a new video posts, kasi I make a lot of these videos every week. So thank you guys sa lahat ng mga nag-share nitong channel na to sa inyong mga friends. I appreciate that a lot. Kasi ang goal ko talaga is to build a bigger community of learners para mas marami tayong matulungan sa mga exams for you to achieve your dreams. Alright? So again, this is part of the revamped series natin on fractions. Today, we're going to talk about dividing fractions. So kung hindi nyo pa napaparad yung ibang parts ng series ito, click here to catch up kasi mas maganda if equipped kayo with that as we face this next video. So if hindi pa, pause nyo muna to, balikan nyo na lang ako. Okay? Pero if you have, let's go ahead and talk about this. In order for me to explain better itong gagawin natin, I'm going to switch over to my PC so I can show you how to do it. I'll see you in a bit. Alright, let's talk about dividing fractions, okay? So, ang rule natin is this, you can only work with fractions. It's the same rule for multiplication. Kasi kung tutuusin, dividing is just kabaliktaran ng multiplication. Now, ano ang process dito? Ang process dito is like this. If you have fractions like these, all you have to do is to change it into multiplication at baliktarin yung pangalawang number. So, in 2 over 3 divided by 1 over 6 will turn into 2 over 3 times, and then, again, babaliktarin mo to. So, yung 6 mapupunta sa taas, 6 over 1. Okay? So, this becomes 2 times 6. Imamatch mo lang siya, yung same na ginagawa natin sa fractions, sa multiplying ng fractions, which I discussed in an earlier video. 2 times 6 is 12 over 3. So, the answer here is going to be 4. Okay? That is your answer. And again, if you mastered yung ating guessing or guesstimation doon sa last video, you'll kind of get kung ano yung tama sagot dito rin if in case meron kang options. Okay? It gets harder kung meron ka ng ganyan. Kung meron ng mga digits, kung ito ay mixed number na. So, that's what we're going to talk about in detail here. Alright, so ito yung explanation, yung method natin. Same problem na pinlash ko kanina sa screen. Ang una natin gagawin, step by step kasi natin itong gagawin, is to convert them into improper fractions. So, that's what we're going to do here. 2 times 3 plus 2. So, 6 plus 2 is 8 over 3 divided by 3 times 6 is 6 to 18 plus 1. So, 19 over 6. Next step, we're going to flip the second fraction over. And then, of course, gagawin natin itong multiplication. So, 8 over 3 times. And then, baliktad nito, 6 over 19. Okay? Next thing we're going to do, match and multiply. So, again, silang dalawa. You have 48 over 3 times 19, which is going to give you 57. Okay? And then, i-convert mo siya into a mixed number or lowest terms kung pwede pa siyang i-lowest terms. Kung hindi, yun na yung final answer. Pero in this case, since pareho silang divisible sa 3, and I know that because of yung video ko on GCF, kung hindi nyo pa yun napanood, panoorin nyo na lang para bumilis kayo dito sa part na to. Okay? Divide ko siya sa 3, that will give you 1, and then 6, 12, 18, 6, 16 over 19. Okay? So, 16 over 19. Wala ka nang magagawa dyan since wala na silang common factor. So, this is your final answer. Okay? So, again, itong process na to, practice na practice kayo with practice. This should be so natural na sa inyo the more that you do it. And it will make sense kung madali na to sa inyo kasi, discuss na yan ng elementary. Pero, i-refresh natin yung sarili natin para lalo pa tayong bumilis. Practice na practice. Kung meron kayong booklet, sagutan nyo siya. Okay? Alright, so ito yung quick quiz natin on dividing fractions. Kung at any point you find this too hard or too difficult, go ahead and go back to the video lesson na lang. Okay? Pero I'll give you 3 minutes to answer these 3 problems and your timer starts now. Thank you.
Alright, let's see how you did. Okay? Alright, so yung first natin na problem here, 8 over 9 divided by 1 over 4. So again, first thing that we're going to do is to flip it over. So 8 over 9 times, and then babalik tarin natin to. This will be 4 over 1. So this will be 8, 16, 24, 32 over 9. And since wala naman ng pwedeng lowest terms dito, ang gagawin na lang natin is i-convert natin siya into a mixed number. So, ilang 9 meron sa 32? What you could do would be 32 divided by 9. Or, kung comfortable ka na with your numbers, you'd know na 9, 18, 27 yung pinakamalapit. So, tatlo yon. 27. So, 32 minus 27 is 5. So, meron kang 3 and 5 over 9. So, that is your answer. You have 4 over 5 divided by 2 and 1 fourth. Again, ang gagawin natin, kailangan pareho muna silang fraction. So, 4 over 5, tapos ito ako convert ko siya into an improper fraction. 2 times 4 is 8, plus 1 is 9. So, magiging time, divided by, muna, 9 over 4. And then, para maging multiplication siya, babaliktarin ko tong side na to. So, magiging 4 over 5 times, and then, baliktad to, 4 over 9. Tapos, pwede ko na siya isolve. So, match. We have 16 over 5 times 9, which is 45. And since wala na akong maisip na factor dyan, wala nang posible, that becomes my answer. Hindi na kasi ito pwede i-divide sa 2, hindi na pwede sa 3, hindi na pwede sa 4, hindi na pwede by itself. So, yan na yung sagot ko, 16 over 45. Okay, I hope you got that right. Now, next. Quick quiz ali, ito, pareho na ngayon silang mixed number. So, again, same thing, i-convert muna natin siya. 4 times 5 is 20 plus 4, that is 24. Over 5 divided by, again, 1 times 3 plus 2, that is 5 over 3. Tapos, para maging multiplication siya, babaliktarin ko yung isa. So, 24 over 5 times, kabaliktaran nito, which is going to give you 3 over 5. So, 24 times 3 is 60 plus another 12, so that is 72 over 5 times 5, which is 25. So, the answer here will be, dalawang 25 kasi to, I 50, right? So, you have that dalawa, and then 72 minus 50, which is 22 over 25. Since wala na silang common factor, that becomes my answer. Okay? Kung naguluhan kayo, sige naman ako dito, ano lang yan, ganyan lang kasimple yan, no? Dinivide ko lang siya. Parang ginagawa natin dati. Kaya lang, ginawa ko na lang siya sa brain para mas mabilis na ako. Hindi kailangan isulat lahat. Okay? So, again, I hope you got that right. Ingat-ingat lang sa pagko-convert at saka sa pag-multiply, sa pagbali-baliktad. Kasi kung ibiglaan nyo siya i-multiply, magkakamali kayo ng sagot. Make sure na bago mo i-change yung multiplication, na baliktad mo muna siya.
Alright, I hope you learned something today. If you did, click thumbs up. Make sure to share this video with your friends, lalo na kung mag-exam din sila para mas marami tayong matulungan. And if you want to get a copy of the reviews that I made, including the workbook, kung saan makakita kayo ng exercise on this topic, you can go to www.facebook.com/teamlyqa to find out how you can get your own copy. There are also upcoming live review events and the online review program and all of the resources that I have na nandun sa page na yun. So if you want to join us, you can go to that page for more information. Thank you guys for watching. Never stop learning. Aja aja, kaya yan. I'll see you in my next video and bye for now.